Hey everyone, Nick here, and today I have a new video for you in our Analyzing Zip Code series. So in our last video, we took our zip code list and we used VLOOKUP formulas to look up information like city, county, and state from a list of zip codes that we had. And we used the United States Postal Service zip code database to pull into our own zip code list using those VLOOKUP or XLOOKUP formulas. And you can check those two videos out previous to this. But now we need to summarize our zip code list, or rather we need to summarize the variables that we created from our zip code list. So we need to summarize things like city, county, and state. How many visitors came from all the cities that we had, all the counties that we had, and the states that we had. And this is what we need to do by analyzing it, looking at it, inserting a pivot table into our data. Now we could go through and just hand count every single one that we saw here. That would take us days and weeks and months, way too difficult. So let's go ahead and insert a pivot table. All you need to do that, make sure each of your columns has a header that you want to include in the analysis. Go ahead and just click and drag over all of the columns there. Go up to the Insert tab, click on Insert Pivot Table there. And then it's going to ask you if you want it on a new worksheet or existing worksheet. I like to put it on a new worksheet. There's our pivot table here. And over here, you can see these are all of our variables. These are the column headers over here. This is where we're going to put some of those things. We have a filter box here on the left. We're not going to deal with that right now. We have the rows and columns box, and then we have the values box. Right now, values is most important. So what I like to do is take our number column. This is our ID column, and put it into the values. And as soon as you do that, you can see a table pops up here on the left. It says 465. That's weird. It's actually giving us a sum of the ID of the numbers that show up in that ID column. So it's going 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. So we don't want it to do that. We want it to show counts instead of sums. So in order to change the unit there, just go ahead and click on the little drop-down menu, go to the value field settings here, and you can see sum is selected. Now click on count and then click OK. And when you do that, it updates to counts, and it says 30, and that's perfect. That means that I have 30 rows of data in my table. I have 30 zip codes in my data. Very nice. So now if I wanted to see how many zip codes came from the cities that I have, I'm going to go ahead and click on the city variable here and drag it into rows. And once I do that, you can see all the cities pop up here. And then over here, the count, that shows you how many of those cities showed up in my database. So you can see 1 for Battle Creek, down here 10 for Holland. If I wanted to summarize this a little bit more nicely, I would sort this data greatest to least. And all you need to do that is click in this top row here, right click, and then go ahead and go to sort, and then say largest to smallest, and that will sort all of your data. And now you can see that I have the most zip codes that I had in my database came from Holland, Michigan, and then there are other cities represented there too. Now once you click in here, you can also just drag those out. So now it's back to my base table here. What about county? Let's go to county there. Did the same thing. Let's drag that out. Let's go to state and let's see how many states are represented. It looks like I have 4 states represented here. I have Michigan, Colorado, New York, and Washington. I'm going to go ahead and just sort that data again. Right click, largest to smallest. Most of my data comes from Michigan, and then a few visitors came from Colorado, came from Washington, and came from New York. So this is a pretty cool way, an easy way that you can summarize data that you have, not just zip codes, but any type of data that you have. Go ahead and try it. You can't break it, so just click the undo button as you wish. If you like this video, I hope you give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more updates on data design, Excel, and PowerPoint tutorials. Hopefully you like this video, and we'll see you next time.